What's up, y'all? It's Dmajini, and it's time for another one. And guess what? Another day, and yet another excuse coming from the show media. Listen, the crazy thing about this is that I would like to talk about something good about Star Wars. I really do. I really wish there was something good to talk about, but it just seems like every time I turn around, it's something crazy coming out that side of the media, or whatever they think they're doing over there. So this is an article coming from Screen Rant, and it says, The Last Jedi comic shows Rey never beat Luke. So I want to again say this, like I've said before, and just to give you guys an understanding. If you have to create a book, a novel, a comic book, a cartoon, whatever you have to do to try to gloss over, clean up, you know, do whatever you got to do to make this movie or any movie look better, you didn't do a good job. Just that simple. I mean, it's just like you guys are, you're saying it without saying it, and it's very frustrating. Because this is it just annoys me, because it's saying how it talked about how it gave Leia's perspective when she's in space. Really? Why would that be a thing anyway? That it gave Admiral Akbar his last words. Really? Why did you just do that in the movie? Matter of fact, why did you just kill him off like that in the first place? But anyway, let's get into what I'm talking about here. So, and I will have this, you know, description down there inside the comments. But it says, you know, when they were fighting, this happens. So basically what it's saying is that while Luke and Rey was doing a little tussle and bustle, Luke slips, falls down. So him losing his footing was why it seemed like Rey became the aggressor. First off, Rey shouldn't have been the aggressive, period. Because this happened just about maybe, I'll give them 2 weeks from the last movie. 2 weeks. I'll give you 2 weeks. Because she handed him his lightsaber in the beginning of this movie. How is it? I don't care if you train on Jakku, whatever. I'll say this again. Master Infila, during the Jedi Barash Purge, he took the Jedi Barash code during the Purge, because he you know, it's basically taking penance. When you cut yourself off from the Force. Nearly killed Darth Vader in the height of he just turned Darth Vader, so he's still young. He still has a lot of fuming hatred. Granted, he needs some things to learn, but he's still young. And mind you, he was still injured, but it doesn't matter. He was still young, and this guy, this master, nearly killed Vader. You can't tell me, no matter how much time Luke took off, there's somebody who is a novice. She was basically talking about a youngling. I don't care. A young, basically, trying to be a master, and you're gonna make an excuse for that. Say, oh well, he slipped. That's why he fell. Really, he slipped? That's what you do. That's what we're going with right now. That's what's hot on the streets. Oh, he slipped. And never mind the fact that they're bringing up how old Luke is. Count Dooku was supposed to be in his 80s and took on Obi-Wan and Anakin and beat them both in the Attack of the Clones. I'm just saying, you can't sit there and tell me that it's, oh, Luke was old. That's crazy talk, man. You know, I would say that you're trying to insult my intelligence and insult, you know, the fandom's intelligence, but it's really just insulting yourself at this point. Because it's like, every time I turn around, you guys are doing something ridiculous. You need comics to explain all this nonsense. Really? Come on, man. And then you know, it has it, you know, the shield who's doing this is Andrew Dice, right? And he's talking about how, oh no, nobody's remaking episode 8. Come on, we know that wasn't happening. You guys are just really, we know you guys are doubling down on it. You're not gonna redo episode 8. You know, it's just insane. And you know, and it says, and he says in there, let the fans decide if this eases disappointment. No, it doesn't ease anything. This movie sucked, and you guys keep pointing out the parts that suck, and then be like, oh, well, you guys didn't have any, but you're pointing out the exact reasons why we didn't like the movie, but at the same time, you say, oh, well, you know, maybe, you know, you guys are just not really, you know, comprehending it. Really? We're not comprehending it? But you're bringing up the exact issue that we're talking about? How is a novice going to be a master? I don't care what you say. Lucas, and just the way they made Luke anyway is just disrespectful anyway. It's just disrespectful. I don't care how many times I got to say it. It just is. And speaking of which, since we're on the subject of Rey and her unstoppable power, you know, right now we're kind of transitioning into the point where we got to start worrying about episode 9. Again, what do we have? Can somebody out there, anybody who, I'm putting this out to people who are pro Disney's Lucasfilm right now. What do you have that is exciting? What are you excited for about episode 9? Just give me some answers, because I can tell you right now, and I can speak for the Phantom Menace for the most part, and the Spellbreakers for the most part, that, you know, we really don't have anything that we're excited for. I'm looking for all the pro Disney people out there. The pro Disney Lucasfilm, let me get that correct. What are you looking forward to in episode 9? Tell me about that, please. Just write it down. If you got it, no judging here. Just please, just tell me what is so excited about episode 9 that we're going into. Because, you know, every time you turn around, you're bringing up new excuses about this movie. We what? 8 months now? 8 months passes and we're still talking about The Last Jedi? This article was written 2 days ago. 8 months? We're 8 months away from that movie and we're still talking about the excuses levels that we have for a movie that they said it was, you know, according to Ryan Johnson, had no problems. But we keep pointing out the problems that we're distinctly telling you about. Stuff like this. So please, all the pro Lucasfilm Disney fans out there, let me know what you like. And obviously, you know, Phantom Menace, Spellbreakers, y'all can let me know about how y'all feel about this new comic that's coming out, you know, that came out, whatever. You know, this whole thing is just, it's just hogwash to me. How y'all feel about this and the constant excuse they keep making. And again, like I said, we 8 months past since this movie. We should be worried about what episode 9 is. You know, right, you know, after The Force Awakens, you know, regardless of how much of a copy and paste it was, I was excited about The Last Jedi. When they came, I said, oh, Last Jedi's coming out. Everybody's excited about it. When I was excited, everybody was excited about The Last Jedi. You know, before we knew what of a, you know, pile of crap it was going to be, everybody was hype about it. Where's the hype for 9? You know, at this point, at least give us a working title to see what we get. We could, you know, wrap our minds around a little bit. But no, it's because there's nothing. You have nothing. You guys squandered your opportunity, and now we're still talking about The Last Jedi and how these things of, you know, the excuses for them. Yeah. But anyway, Like, share, and subscribe, and I'll catch y'all later. Peace. Definite course, caution, you lost, kid. I don't take a win.